This is Africa. And in this place of beauty, there is an ugliness that infests the land. He's called a jackal. He has turned a brother against brother. And run the rivers red with their blood for his own profit. How can such a man be stopped?
How do you stop a man who has the power to turn a nation into a graveyard? They'll send someone.
Okay, go.
Hey, sir. Sorry for the delay.
So you going to your hotel in Pala?
Yeah, I know.
It's lucky for you, Pala. It's only one hotel. Still working.
See that?
I won't see any more very soon. It's probably the last one having this country. Full of rich people. Only money and connections can get you out of it. I told you the plane's gone, but they don't believe me. Everyone thinks the big planes are coming back. Who can say anymore?
Where are you?
My passenger, driving him to the hotel in town.
You come from the airport?
Yes, sir. The airport. Gentlemen, you are posted here all day. Yeah. On my way back, I grab some cold beer. You drink beer?
Yeah, beer. We drink beer. Hurry up then. Move along.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. See you soon, sir. Troops nowadays. It's okay. They keep to themselves most of the time. Don't let this concern you. Just poisoning your steam, right? You remember how you. Okay, sir, we are here. We made it to that. Hey, are you okay? You don't look so good. You tired?
The target's presence in the state continues to be a destabilizing influence. He's largely responsible for the recent influx of weapons into the country in clear violation of the Joint Signatory Framework. His reputation as a dangerous arms dealer is well deserved. Orders are to terminate. Well, that didn't work out the way they planned. I'm still breathing, and you're the one with malaria. You can tell them you tried, but that means fuck all, doesn't it? You're fired. You know it, and so do I. You had your shot, but now it's over. And since men like you only work for money, you're no longer my problem. You'll have to find something else to do with yourself now. What your old clients don't seem to understand is that they can't kill me. Do you understand what I'm saying? Nobody kills me. Nobody. I'm the one who decides who lives and who dies. Me. You know, there's a book I read a long time ago. I still think about it every day. It helps me understand life out here. The book talks about men, about what motivates them. Simple, really. A living being seeks above all else to discharge his strength. Life itself is will to power. Nothing else matters. So long.
Sergeant.
You're a mess, man. That business looks nasty. My name is Carbonell. I don't care what your name is. You're just the problem right now. Who are you working with? You got some of my guys killed at the hotel, you know that? So I think you work for me now. I've got a few errands for you, errand boy. Get on out here. Get yourself kitted up. There's ammo and meds for you. Alright, listen up, Slick. The shit really hit the fan back in town. There was supposed to be a ceasefire, but that's all out the window now. I work for a guy named Kakumba, local boss for the United Front. I've got all my decent guys out in the field trying to keep the APR from making a land grab. So that just leaves you to take care of the monkey work. First thing, I need to get that piece of shit coupe outside back on the road. You look like a vocational school dropout. Go out there and see if you can get the engine running. Try not to get distracted between the door and the car. You look like you're gonna drop dead any second. Guard!
with your mobile, you think you can pull up a raid? The APR's got a forward position half a clip south of here. If something bad happened to the shithead standing lamppost, no one would ever know. Go take him out.